Start the class today. Yesterday we saw what is called probability, chance and probability. We will take chances in the life sometimes, like taking a waiting list ticket and waiting for a confirmation in the train for a journey. Sometimes we will also think that there won't be any rain and don't take umbrella, and that day it may be a rainy day. Fully we may drench and come back. All these are certain happenings, certain chances of happening in our day-to-day life. Similarly, all these can be linked with our this one. We can measure this uncertainty, and that measurement is called probability. Measuring the uncertainty is called probability. How much sure are an event may be, how much uncertain an event may be, that can be measured like this. For example, a game is started. Before the start of a game, we will the captains will go into the field and go for a toss. And the toss is like tossing a coin. For both the teams, there are equal chances. We say here the outcomes may be head or tail. They are equally likely. They are equally likely. Okay, yesterday we have checked all these cases. Now today we'll continue that exercise. More questions are there in the exercise. Through the present screen I will do that. So wait for that present screen option, children. All of you look onto the on your screens. Everything will be visible to you. Now I am going to present the screen for you. Now, are you able to see the third question on the screen?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Very good. It is clear.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good, good. You can stop talking now. Now, you see, a spinning wheel is having five letters in it, five sectors. Each sector is marked with a letter, but letter A came two times. So here the outcomes are A, B, C, D only, but total number of outcomes will be 5 again, 5. And we are asked to find the probability of the point stopping on the letter D. So here the total outcomes are 5, event is pointer stopping on D. Let me have this one, pointer stopping on letter D. That is the event. Therefore, what are the possibilities here? Let us calculate. Yesterday I told you this formula also. The event happens only one time here, because only one letter, one particular sector is marked as E. When you rotate this particular spinning wheel, it may stop at D in one particular case only. Only one D is there. So probability of the event is, probability of the event is 1 out of 4 chances, 1 out of 4 total outcomes, 5 total outcomes. So 1 by 5 number of outcomes in that make the event is only 1 outcome only will make our event, and the total number of outcomes of this experiment is 5. So 1 by 5 is the probability. Now let us check. Another question is given here. Find the probability of getting an ace from a well-shuffled deck of 52 playing cards. You might have seen playing cards. Have you all seen these playing cards?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Playing cards are, of course, they are available in every house. You can see these. There are 52 playing cards, but there are 4 groups in it. Group 1. One color, one particular symbol called diamonds is there. Group 2, clubs. This symbol is called clubs. Group 3, that is hearts symbol. And group 4, that is a spades symbol. 4 types of symbols will be there. In each group, there are 13 cards. Starting with the letter A. Letter A, B, C, A. After that, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, etc. Numbers will be there. After that, letters Z. J, Q and K will be there. These are called playing cards. So this letter A is called ace. Letter A stands for ace, J for jack, Q for queen, K for king. So there are totally 1, 2, 3, 4 aces in the total deck of 52 cards. So now here the total outcomes is 52, and event is getting an ace. Event is getting an ace. How many aces are there? 4. So our event occurs 4 times only. Our event will be true only in 4 cases. So probability of the event is number of outcomes that makes the event is 4, and total number of outcomes of the experiment is 52. 4 by 52 is the probability. You may leave at this stage, but if you want, you can also simplify the fraction 4 ones, 4 thirteens, and you can make it as 4 by 13 also. So 1 by 13 also. 1 by 13 is the simplest fraction for this one. So that is the probability of this event. So there are 4 aces in a deck of 52 cards. So 52 is the total outcomes, 4 is the outcomes we require. Therefore, it is, who is joining? And I don't know. Right. So for this one. Now, if ace is asked for your writing, suppose you are asked to find how many k's, what is the, suppose event is getting k, what is the probability? Can anybody tell me what is the probability if k is given? Pranamya, can you tell me if k you want from this, what is the probability?
So 1 by 52, sir.
Again, 4 by 52, 4 by 52. K, there are 4 k's, no?
Okay, sir.
4 by 52.
Yes, sir.
Even q also same.
Okay, sir.
Even j also the same. If you want one particular color card, there, see, 1, 2, 3, all these 13 are red colored. These 13 also are red colored. If you want red colored
sir,
card,
sir, 2 by 52, sir.
What?
Sir, if you want color, sir, then we should write 2 by 52.
2 by 52, no. If you want only one colored card, not K, not J, like that. Suppose I am shuffling all these 52 cards. When I take out a card, it should be a red colored card. In that case, there are 26 red colored cards. Therefore, 26 by 52 is the probability, or it is half, 1 by 2 we can say. Okay, all this you learn in higher classes. Anyway, what is given in the textbook we have answered. Now we go for the third question. C. Here are some apples. Apples are good, no?
Sir, all these questions you will send PDF, sir.
I have sent, but I am discussing again here so that everybody can understand. Okay, now, see, here are the apples. 7 apples are there totally. There are, some are green colored, some are red colored. How many red are there? 4. How many green colored are there?
4.
Green color?
3.
So, you are asked to find the probability of getting a red apple. So, what is the event here? Getting a red apple without looking into the basket. In the basket, we kept all this. Without looking into the basket, I took out an apple. It should be red. Then, what is the probability? There are four apples.
So, 4 by 7, sir?
4 by 7.
4 by 7, sir.
Very good, very good. You are all right. 4 by 7 is the right answer. Suppose I ask for green apple, then?
3 by 7.
Very good, 3 by 7. Very good, very good. 3 by 7 is the right answer. Now,
yes, sir.
Another question is given, fourth question here. In a box, there are cards with numbers 1 to 10. There are cards with numbers 1 to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. They are all some cards. Each card, one number is there. One digit we put, or one number we put. And all these are kept in a box. So, totally how many numbers? 10. So, the total outcomes is 10 now. Total outcomes is?
Sir, I will answer, sir.
wait. I did not ask you any question. Why are you answering? Wait. Event there are three di- four different events are asked. For each event we want to find the probability. So I made it a tabular. In a tabular form I am putting it now. For the first event, getting a number 6, outcomes, how many outcomes are there, what is the probability, I am writing. So event, outcomes for the event, making the event, and probability of that particular event. Like this I am making the tabular form. Suppose you are asked to get a number 6 from this one. What is the probability? How many outcomes can make the event? Only one.
Ten, sir.
Therefore,
one, sir.
Therefore, the probability is 1 out of 10 chances. So, 1 by 10 here. Now, another question is getting a number less than 6. Less than 6, 1, 2,
5 by 10,
4, 5. So, 5 are there. So, 5 by 10. You can also make this number smaller. How much, can you tell me, if you make it smaller, how much you will get?
1 by 2.
1
by 2, sir.
5 can be reduced. 5 can be reduced in both. 5, 1s are 5 and 5, 2s are 10. So it can be equal to 1 by 2 also. 1 by 2 also. I am making it 1 and here I am making it 2. So, even if you don't reduce like this, it's not wrong, children. It is not wrong. It can be right. Even 5 by 10 if you write, we will give you points. Okay. Right. But you can, you learn how to put it in the smallest form, in the short, in the most small form, like this. Right? Conveniently you can write like this. Getting a number greater than 6. Greater than 6. So, how many numbers are greater than
7 by 10, sir? So, 4 by 10, sir, because 4 numbers are there.
There are after 4 six. Numbers which are greater than 10, which are greater than 6. Greater than 6, 4 numbers are there, 7, 8, 9, 10. Therefore, outcomes making our event here, what is the event? Getting number greater than 6. So, 4 by 10 is the answer. Now, getting a one digit number. How many one digit numbers are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Very good, very good. Only 10 is not the one digit number, it's a two digit one. So 9 1 digit numbers are there, therefore it is 9 by 10 correct answer now. Now I am going to I'm going to teach you what is the fifth problem here. Fifth problem from this exercise. Here is a spinning wheel again. In the spinning wheel, 5 sectors are marked. 3 are colored green. 1 is colored blue. The other one is colored red. Now here, what is the total number of outcomes when this spinning wheel is rotated? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 is the total number of outcomes. It is nothing but the total number of sectors. Now the question asked here is, what is the probability of getting a green sector? Green sector you want. There are 3 green sectors. Therefore, 3 green sectors are there. Therefore, 3 by 5. Number of non-blue sectors, which are not blue. Non-blue sector is the next this question. Non-blue sector is 4 by 5. Okay, this is the answer for the fifth question. In the sixth question, they asked us again to find the probabilities of the events in question 2. In question 2, what is given? A die is thrown, list the outcomes of an event, getting a prime number, not getting a prime number, getting a number greater than 5, getting a number greater than, not greater than 5. These are the 4 questions given. Now let us see. A die is thrown means you can get one up or two up, 3 up, 4, 5 or 6 up. So how many outcomes are there totally?
6.
6 outcomes.
6.
Very
six,
good.
Sir.
Right. Now, suppose you want a prime number. outcomes for this event is, 1 is not a prime number, 2 is a prime number, 3 is a prime number, 5 is a prime number. So 1 as 2, 3, 5. So 3 prime numbers are there in these, among these outcomes. So 3 is the number of outcomes that makes the event here. So 3 by 6 is the probability, 3 outcomes, our outcomes, and 6 is total outcomes. So 3 by 6 is the probability, but it can be made into a simplest fraction as 1 by 2, because 3 1 are 3, 3 2 are 6. Now not getting a prime number. So leaving 2, 3, 5, all other numbers are not prime numbers. 1 is neither prime nor composite. So 1 you can take 4 and 6. So 1, 4 and 6 are the non-prime numbers. So there are 3 outcomes which make the event. Therefore, 3 is the outcomes for this event. Probability is again 3 by 6, again 1 by 2. Did you understand this question? Now next one is,
yes sir.
A number greater than 5. Obtaining a number greater than 5 when a die is thrown. Greater than 5, how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All these
one
are
by five, sir.
All these are less than 5 or equal to 5. This is 5 is less than equal to 5. Not greater, not lesser. So only one number is there which is greater than 5. So therefore only one outcome makes the event here. So what is the event? Getting a number greater than 5. So therefore 1 is the outcome for us. 1 out of 6 outcomes, total outcomes. Therefore 1 by 6 is the probability. Now the last question here in this, a number not greater than 5. Not greater than
5 by 6.
Right. It is 5 by 6. So, all the questions are answered, and you have to note down these questions in the classwork now. Then will you not? So, shall I keep one question after another question for you? So, I'll tell you. Because it is computer and I'm not drawing the pictures. But if I ask you to draw the pictures, it is a difficult thing for you. So there is no need of drawing pictures anywhere. Only I want the question and answer you have to write. So children, I am going to send this PDF to you again today. All those who did not receive the earlier PDF, write down these questions in your classwork. And homework, of course, yesterday, try these questions I gave you as homework. Today there is no homework. Instead, I give you one particular exercise, one chapter I'm going to revise for you. And all those questions we will discuss now. Certain questions and certain concepts we discuss here from that particular chapter. And on that chapter, we are going to have a test tomorrow. So shall I stop the screen share and talk to you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir.
Very good. So, children.
Yes, sir.
All of you should be in the Google class for me. Google class. In the Google class, so far some 8-10 children joined, I think. I want to check how many children joined. One second. So far in Google class, 16 students joined. So all of you join in Google class using one ID I gave you yesterday. I shared one ID yesterday. HYA, some ID is there, no? Using that class ID, share that ID if you, I'll share that ID if you want again. All of you join the class.
Sir.
Tell me.
Sir, 15 students joined, sir.
15, but 16 are there on my list here.
Yes, sir. Sir, including you, sir, it's 16, sir.
Oh, I'm also there as a part here.
Yes, sir. No, sir, you are a teacher, sir. Students are different, sir.
Students are different. Okay, no problem. People here are, okay. Whatever it is, but you need to keep your name as your ID here. Otherwise, I don't understand who is this. Somebody kept like this. You have to keep your name, children. Otherwise, I don't understand who are you. So change.
I kept my name and classes.
Yeah.
Roll number, sir.
Karen, from you, I don't have any problem. Somebody kept a name like this. Panduranga app, Panduranga app, op, etc. Is there somebody's name? I don't know who is that.
Moksha, sir.
Moksha, join today. Where is Moksha? Moksha.
Yes.
You change your Google ID so that we will have your name on the class. Okay. Right. Now let us.
Sir, Vijay, sir, and Sakit sir. Vijay Kumar sir told to first keep your roll number. Afterwards, sir, keep your name, sir.
Okay. That's good. Yesterday. I got one, this one, I gave you homework yesterday, and the homework was submitted only by one student yesterday. You understand? Homework was given, and that is submitted only by one student. And 14, out of 15 students, one graded, one turned, okay, two more, Lasya also submitted the homework. Lasya and Subham submitted the homework, and all others have to submit the homework. So yesterday's homework you all submit. Today I am not giving you any special homework, only reading work. What is that reading homework? You have to read the previous lesson. On this lesson we will have test next week. Previous lesson test is, what is the previous lesson? Understanding quadrilaterals. Quickly we will recall what we have learned in that chapter. Shall we recall all those? I will ask you questions orally. You all please answer. Whenever I ask somebody, that somebody will only answer, not all. Okay. Subham, we'll start with Subham first. Subham, are you there? Subham is there.
Yes, sir.
Very good. You have to answer the question first. A parallelogram is a square. Is it true or false? A parallelogram is also a square. Is it true or false? Be quick, please. Subham? No? Okay. Junaid?
Sir, Sakit, I will answer, sir. I'm Sakit.
Wait. I will give you a chance, Sakit. Wait. Subham is not answering anyway. Leave it. Junaid, can you only true? You see, if you don't know the answer, you can take a chance. No, why don't you take a property? True or false, you can say. One of them you can say, no. I'm not giving you points right now.
True, sir.
True. Who is telling? Junaid is telling. It is not true, it is false. Answer is false. So, parallelogram is not a square, but square is a parallelogram. Reverse is true. Okay? Now, Sneha will answer now. In a parallelogram, Sneha, are you there? Ready? Right.
Yes, sir.
Right, good. I understood. In a parallelogram, the diagonals bisect each other. Is it true or false?
True, sir.
True, correct. Diagonals bisect each other. Now, Saket. Square is called a regular quadrilateral. True or false?
True, sir.
Very good. Now, Sri Shruti. Sri Shruti will answer. A rectangle is also a square. True, false? Only true, false you have to tell me correctly. A rectangle is also a square.
Sir.
A rectangle is also a square.
Sir, once repeat the question.
You have to tell me answer in true or false only. Only two options for you. True, false. A rectangle is also a square.
Yeah. False, sir.
Right. It is false.
False, sir.
Correct. Rectangle is not a square, but square is a rectangle. Other way around it is right. Now I want answer from P. Sai Karthik. P. Sai Karthik. Sai Karthik, two are there, no? Two Sai Karthiks are there. P. Sai Karthik will tell.
Yes, sir.
Ready. A kite is a parallelogram. True or false?
Yes, sir.
No, it is not a parallelogram. It is not a parallelogram. It is a special type of quadrilateral. That's it. Okay? Right. Okay, right. No problem. Now, I want Manasa will answer this question now. Manasa ready?
Yes, sir.
A parallelogram, a polygon, in which all sides, all diagonals fall in its interior. What is that particular polygon is called? I'll give you two options, you tell me the correct one. Convex polygon, concave polygon.
Concave.
It is convex. Okay, it's okay, no problem. Because when the diagonals are falling in the interior, then it is convex. If one or more diagonals are falling in the exterior, it is called concave. All right. Now, I want answer from Ramyasri. Ready, Ramyasri? Quick. Another four questions only. I'll put. Ramyasri.
Yes, sir.
Ready. What is the sum of angles of a interior angle? Sum of interior angles of a quadrilateral. Sum of.
True, sir.
I am not asking true false now. What is the sum of interior angles of a quadrilateral? Till now I asked true false questions, but now I am asking like a fill in the blank. It is.
Sir, Saket can answer.
No, Saket cannot answer. Wait, Saket. I want answer from Tejesh. Tejesh.
Sir, can I say?
Sir.
What is the sum of angles of a quadrilateral? Angles. Akshay, answer. Tell me, Akshay.
Sir, 180 degrees.
No, it is
180 degrees.
It is 300.
Sir, can I tell, sir?
It is 360 degrees. I already answered. Tejesh left the meeting also. I don't know. I asked a question and he left the meeting. Nice. Kathisri will answer now. Kathisri, get ready. What is the sum of exterior angles of a quadrilateral? What is the sum of exterior angles of a quadrilateral? Quick.
Sir, can I tell, sir?
Who is that? Pranamya.
Sir, Pranamya.
Wait,
sir, it's 360 degrees, sir.
360 degrees, correct answer. Kathy, you should be quick. Okay.
Okay.
So, right. Now it is 12:53. So, we will break for the attendance. So, all of you, please hold on.